Hi, this is Rhett with TestingTheory.com, and today we're going to talk about A/B testing for product managers. So you have a product, but how do you improve it? You're in charge of this product, but how do you show to your leadership team and management that your management of the product is actually improving it and helping the site? How do you know what features of the product are most valuable, and how do you know who this product matters for? Today, we'll talk about how A/B testing can help you with all of these questions and help you improve your product. So very quickly, why should you be doing A/B testing as a product manager? First and foremost, this is how you increase conversions. When you learn what works for your products, you can then increase the conversions of your site and show value. Second, doing A/B testing is a very clear and concise way to answer your business questions. There are things that you want to know about the product. Why is it working? How do we make it better? A/B testing is your key to answer those questions through data. Who uses it? How do they use it? What features matter to them? These are the questions that you really want to answer, and testing is the key to do that. A/B testing will help you remove the guesswork of optimizing your product because you'll use data, you'll use statistics, you'll use analytics to help you know if the change that you make is good or bad. It helps you remove the biases and the opinions and the assumptions that many product managers use. It gives you the data-driven approach to make good decisions. The other advantage of using A/B testing to optimize your product is that you get to use your target audience to optimize and learn with your product. You're not doing a small sample size or a random survey to a few people. You're actually using the people that come to your site, they engage with your digital app, your digital experiences, and it's those people that are helping you learn about your product. A/B testing gives you large sample sizes, and it also gives you segmentation. So not only do you get to see what works, you get to see who it works for in what circumstances. Another benefit of doing A/B testing as a product manager is you get to quantify the value of a change. So if you make a change by running a test, you can see that the lift of one variation is 30% or 20% or 15% higher than the control. That quantifiable value of that change helps you to quantify the impact of the difference of the things you're making. Another major benefit to doing A/B testing as a product manager is you get to learn what works. It's not about improving the product, it's about learning how to make the product better. As you learn, you can do that with every test. Even if your test loses, if you structure your test correctly, the failing tests help you learn the most. And so the advantage is you never really fail because you're always learning about your product and you're always learning what works for your visitors. The final benefit of why you should do A/B testing, and there's probably more, is that it's also very low risk. If you implement a change that hasn't been tested, you cross your fingers, you hold your breath, you release it, and there's a chance that it may flop, it may bomb, you could really just ruin the visitor experience, you could also ruin your position and your career. With a test, it's low risk because if something fails, first of all, you learn from it like we talked about, but the limited window of the test reduces the failure of that losing experience. And so even if something's really bad and it fails, you know it's just for a couple weeks, and then you can learn from it, move on, and make it better, and you're not just releasing to production, and then you see the conversion numbers tank over time. Testing is a low-risk solution to improve your product and to answer business questions and get your visitors value and help you know what increases conversions. So those are some of the reasons why you should do it. Now, if you're here, you probably are interested in A/B testing or you have some foundation of what A/B testing is, but in its simplest form, it's comparing one variation to another variation. You have a control that doesn't change and you put a variation out there that you want to learn about and test, and you see if this variation increases the conversions of your visitor experience compared to the control. That lift, that difference between the variations is how you quantify the value of the change. A/B testing is about changing something and seeing if it improves the visitor experience. If you want to know more about the types of tests you can run, I have a whole video on that, but you don't just have to do A/B, you can do ABN, you can do multivariate, you can do a personalization test. There's lots of ways to test your experiences. So what can you test? You can test pretty much anything. You can test layouts, you can test designs and call to actions and heroes and banners and promotions and pricing. You can test inside your emails, you can test inside your apps, you can test paid ads with social media or paid ads on search. The testing that you can do is unlimited, and it's only limited actually by your imagination. You can test everything that is digital with your experiences. We went through a series of tests with one client where we optimized their navigation. We went from this massive navigation of like 50 different links down to like 15. And we learned that by simplifying and reducing them, we were able to increase the usage and the value of the navigation for the site. We did another test with a client where we're doing a series of tests on the homepage. And we're starting to learn certain elements matter, certain elements don't, different layouts for different audience segments. As you do optimization with your site, you'll see that some things matter for some people and some things don't. With another client that had a lot of content, We test in putting related content next to the content, like a recommendation zone or some other content to help influence the use of that related content without distracting them from the content they're engaging with. That was a great thing to test and it worked for them. With another client, we're optimizing the information architecture of the site. And so we're asking what content should be available and how do we structure that and organize it to make it most accessible for the people using the site. And so as we test the information architecture, we're learning what works for their visitors in a way that's simplified and valuable. Another client that I work with has a lot of media. They have images and videos, and the goal of their site is to get people using it by downloading it. And so we're doing a series of tests where we're testing the site to optimize the download, the engagement with the media experience. And by doing that, we're learning how to optimize the layouts, the page designs to get more people downloading the content that they've created. There's an infinite number of things you can test with A/B testing. And as you get into this, you'll learn to optimize the entire visitor experience, the entire flow. And so you as a product manager will be able to improve your products. You may be wondering what tools you can use to test. And there's actually a lot of those as well. You can use Optimizely. We use Adobe Target. You can use Google Optimize or A/B Tasty or VWO or Convert.com. There's a ton of testing tools out there. And all of them, for the most part, will give you the same value. Some have some bells and whistles, some have others. But for the most part, if you are able to go in and test your visitor experiences with a testing tool, that's all you need. Okay, I want to run through 9 high-level steps of how do you actually get into this? How do you do A/B testing? And the first thing I would recommend is that you get an expert to work with you. If you're new to A/B testing, you may not realize that it's a deep discipline. You know, people that don't know very much, they think that, oh, I got it, I just run tests. It's pretty easy. And the more you realize and the more you know and get into this industry, the more you realize there's more to know, just like any industry. And so I recommend first and foremost, get an expert to help you and guide you. Do as much studying as you can about the discipline and the expertise of A/B testing and multivariate testing. And as you learn conversion rate optimization principles, you can then transition to doing it on your own, but use the expertise of someone else to help you out of the gate. Okay, the first step to actually getting started, once you have your expert, is you want to define the business question that you're trying to answer. You want to know, what are we trying to learn? What are we asking? What problem are we trying to solve? That business question is your first step. Once you have identified your business question that you want to solve, you then go to the second step of brainstorming the things that will work for or that will answer that problem or question. Once you have solutions to the question that you're trying to answer, the next step is to then identify variations that will answer that question, because you might have 3 or 4 different ways of answering the question and solving for that problem. Next, before you launch your test, you want to make sure that you have defined your primary metric. And the primary metric is the thing that matters most on your site. If you're a retail company, it's probably revenue per visitor. If you are a conversion or lead generation company, you want to increase your conversions with every test. You want to make sure that before you run the test, you know your primary metric you're trying to influence. The next step is the fun part. You get to actually test and measure those variations so that you can get that into the wild and get that in front of your actual visitors. The next step is to, once you've deactivated the test, to analyze those results, to look at the data and get in to see if there's a lift, if that lift is statistically significant. Look at the segmentation on the test, see if there are certain people or groups of people that were influenced by the test, and then make some recommendations based on that data. And then finally, you want to take action on that. You test to learn, and then once you've learned something, you take action on it. That could be something that is implemented on the site, hard-coded for real. It could also mean that you just repeat the process, which is the next step. No matter what you do, after you've learned something, you want to repeat the process, define a new business question, and go through the steps again. So briefly, that's how you do it. Those are the steps to get started testing. All the best product managers I've worked with have one thing in common. They use data to drive their decisions. They're open to being wrong because they want to learn what works best for their visitors. And they use causal data. The conversion rate optimization is the best way to get causal data because you're comparing a change, the change of one element with the change of another element. And that change gives you causation. And so the best product managers I know use causation and data to make decisions. As a product manager, A/B testing is your ticket to improving your product because you can see what works and what doesn't for your visitors. You can learn through causation. You can actually have a quantifiable impact on the organization by using data to make these decisions. If you like this video, please give me that thumbs up so I know you liked it. And please visit me at testingtheory.com where you can see more content just like this. Testingtheory.com really is where the best testers come to increase their conversions and do better testing.